Hi, and welcome to my tutorial on how to create your money cards here in Cricut Design Space. For the sake of this tutorial, I'll show you how to upload the files onto the software, as well as how to design your own money cards. So here we go. So this is the welcome page. This is the home page for Cricut Design Space. And then you will go to the top right-hand corner, click New Project. In New Project, it takes you to a brand new canvas, which is blank. You'll go to your bottom left and click Upload. And from Upload, you have this page here. You upload your images. Now you can either drag and drop your files or you can browse. I'm going to choose to browse. It's going to take me to the file that I have my templates in. So whatever device you're using, be it your tablet, desktop, or laptop, you will click and browse the files that you need, open it up, and click the pieces that you want to work with. I'm going to show you how to upload the back since the front is already uploaded. Whenever you click your files, you get the three choices. And the files have to be JPEG, PNG, anything other than SVG, you'll have choices. I always click complex. This is where you can actually remove the background, but my background is already removed because it's a PNG, which is a transparent background. I have the choice now of cut image or print and then cut image. I'm going to print then cut. And now it's uploaded to my library. Now to upload the SVG, which is the file to create the little plastic window, I will click browse. It takes me back to the same file. I will click my SVG. And as you can see, the other option, you were given three to choose from, and then you could choose cut image and then print and cut. SVGs, you don't have that option. Just click upload and it's now there in your library. So I'm going to show you how to change the basic cut lines into score lines for your little window that will display your money. When you upload it, it's going to come out as 4.222 by 2 by 056. As you can see, everything is a basic cut line. We don't want that. So when you highlight it, top right hand corner says ungroup. Click that. You're going to have to do that two times. And now you will see that everything is separate. This is the basic cut area that you're going to need. And that's the outline that actually makes the shape. And these are the lines inside that are supposed to be score lines, but they're not. So let me put that back on there. And so you will highlight the lines on the inside. You will see on the right hand side, it says that everything is basic cut. You are not to ungroup these whatsoever. You are just going to go to your top left, click operation, click score. And now you see all the lines have been changed to a score line. They are still not attached. So what you will do is you will make sure that you highlight both. Go down to your bottom right, click attached. Now you will see everything works together. Now I'm not going to delete it. I'm going to just put it in the background because I'm going to work on the other pieces. And in order to do that, you click the little I and it puts everything away. We will now work with the back and the front of the card. So I'm going to upload the back and the front. When they're uploaded, they're quite big. What you're going to need to do is click on the side to make sure they're separated. When your files are uploaded together, they're always not attached but grouped together. So just click off to the side and make sure they're separate. And then now you're going to highlight both. Go to top here where it says align, click the arrow down, and click centered. Keep them together. So make sure on the screen here they're both highlighted. And you're going to make sure that you go to where it says size. When you click size, you're going to type in manually, and to do that, you're going to unlock them. Click size, and you're going to type in 3.861. And you're going to go over here and click 5.098. Click the lock. It resizes everything for you. When you click off to the side and you separate them, they are both perfectly matched. And then the window here will be the perfect size for the template. Once you've built it, it will fit in there nice and snug. Now what I want to do is I want to design. I'm going to upload again, and I'm going to click the pieces I want to work with. So I want to work with her, class of 2022, and my digital paper. I'll upload all three together. Again, they're going to be huge and they're going to be all together. Make sure that you lock the top. It'll lock all three of them. And then just choose whatever size that it is that you want so that you're able to see everything. And then click off to the side. They're no longer going to be attached to each other. I'm going to move these ones down here. And I'm going to use my digital paper. Now I'm going to work with the side that has no window, and you'll see why. Put your digital paper, whatever you're using, whatever designs you want to use. You're going to resize them to the point where that you're happy with. And you're going to make sure it's on top of the piece that you're working with. You're now going to click off to the side and highlight both. Once you've highlighted both, click slice. Now it's going to look like nothing happened, but when you move everything over, it has actually cut to match perfectly. I no longer need this part here, so I'm just going to click that little X, put that away. I'm going to take this piece here. I'm going to put it away because I no longer need it. Again, I did not delete it. I just put it aside. Now for this part here, I'm going to duplicate it. And the reason being is because I need another piece to work on here. And that's the reason why I actually worked on the back piece, because there's no opening. If I did the reverse, then I'd have an opening and then I have to, it'd be a whole other headache. So now that I have this piece here, I want to make sure that it's aligned perfectly. Highlight both pieces, go to align, click it, click center. Now it's perfectly on there. You're going to do the same thing with the slice. Highlight both, click slice. And now you have two perfectly cut pieces. I'm going to get rid of that one. This one here I'm going to put out of sight. And there you go. And now to design the actual card itself, I'm going to take my clip art. If it appears in the back, just go to arrange and bring to the front. I'm going to resize it until I'm happy. I'm going to take this piece here too, do the same thing. If it's in the back, go to arrange, bring to front. There we go. Maybe make her a little bit bigger. Once I'm happy with my design, I'm going to move this over because, as you can see, you can't really see the 2022, so I'm going to move that over. I'm going to highlight both pieces. I'm going to flatten them. Once they've been flattened, they have now become one piece. I'm going to go off here where it says offset. I'm going to click offset, and I'm going to type in offset. I'm going to click 0.05. Sometimes offset takes a few minutes, or a few seconds, I should say. I'm going to click apply. That's too big. So let's go back. I'm going to click on the project I want to work on, click offset. There we go. Let's see here. Yeah, that seems to be fine. Now, I click the offset. It's showing in black. It's going to make it impossible to see the numbers. So I'm going to turn it white. And so now, you can see. I want to also make sure that my offset is aligned. So I'm going to highlight everything. I'm going to center it. Highlight again. Flatten. And there you have it. And then I'm going to highlight everything here. Oh, sorry. What I like to do also is I like to do... Let me just turn... I'm going to do another offset. I don't know why this one is here. Oh, it's a design space glitch. But this one here, I'm going to do another offset. Same thing, 0.5. I'm going to apply it. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to move the design over just a little bit. And it gives it sort of a shadow effect. And again, I'm going to highlight it. Nope, I'm going to move it till I like the shadow part. There you go. So shadow effect, highlight, flatten. Ignore this one here. There's a glitch in design space, as tends to happen. But we're going to move this one up here. I'm going to resize it a bit smaller so it fits in better. And there you have it. I'm going to highlight everything. Make sure everything is flattened. And then I have my card. I'm going to click make it just to make sure everything will be attached. I have to get rid of that one. So we're going to cancel. Move that one out of the way. Click the eye. So there you go. Go back to make it. If I'm happy with everything, there you go. That's what my card is going to look like. I'm going to cancel that and make sure you save. Go to the top and enter whatever name you want to enter and make sure that it says that it's being saved. As you can see, there was glitches and now it says money card A. I'm good to go. I can print and cut it. If I click make it, it's going to be a print and cut. And I print on 65 pound cardstock. And so once it's been printed and cut, you send it to printer and you do everything you need to do. As well as your little window. If I go to make it now and I click on the part with the window, everything is there from regards to my score lines. And this would be cut on clear plastic or acetate, something that's sturdy so that the window won't cave in. And there you have it.